Hi, this is Gail Pagano, Senior Director of Member Services at Smarter Balanced. As part of our mission to develop high-quality, innovative assessments, data, and tools that help educators, policymakers, and families better prepare students for success in college and careers, we are excited to announce the release of the new Phase 1 features for the Smarter Balanced reporting system. We've added features that provide educators with more actionable information to improve teaching and learning. The Phase 1 features focus on the interim assessments, both the interim assessment blocks, or IABs, and the interim comprehensive assessments, or ICAs. The purpose of this video is to show how to navigate through the reporting system and demonstrate the new features. This is the landing page with links to the interpretive guide that is designed to help educators, families, and other stakeholders interpret interim assessment results. The user guide that describes all the features and detailed instructions for using each feature, and the reporting system overview, a one-pager about the new features and other features to be released in Phase 2. To access the reports, click the login button and sign in. This brings you to the home page. This screen shows the groups assigned to Tina Teacher. Groups may be assigned to educators by a school or district administrator who has the group administrator role. For more information about creating and managing student groups, see the user guide. There are three different search features. Search by student ID, we are adding search by student name in Phase 2. Search by school name, and search by my groups. Notice that there are links to the user guide and interpretive guide on this screen too. Now let's take a closer look at Tina Teacher's Room 7 group. The system defaults to the current school year. This demo site does not have any data for 2017-18. So I will show you results for 2016-17 instead. The reports I'm about to show you are available for 2017-18 in the live reporting system. Please note that the item level information is not available in the live reporting system for 2016-17 or previous school years. This report displays the most recent assessment first. In this case, the Grade 3 Math Number and Operations Fractions IAB. To see all the available assessments for this group, select the plus sign or the Select Assessments button. You can select one or more assessments to view. To view only the overall results for multiple tests, click on Collapse Results. Now I will deselect all of the tests except for the Grade 3 Number and Operations Fractions IAB. This test was administered in two different sessions. By clicking on the sessions, we see that the report updates based on the selected test sessions. This report shows the number of students tested, the average scale score and error band for the selected group of students, and the student score distribution that shows the number or percentage of students who scored within each reporting category, below standard, near standard, and above standard. Click on the Show Value as Number button to switch from percent to number values. The information icons provide a description for each reporting element. This one explains the average scale score and error band. The advanced filters allow you to view results for subgroups of students or by test status. For example, you may want to view results for female students who are of Hispanic ethnicity. By selecting these filters, the reports update to the results for this subgroup of students. To see the individual student results again, click on Expand Results. This report shows the results by student. The report shows each student's reporting category, scale score, and error band. This report also shows the manner of test administration, which in this case was non-standardized. Before we look at the individual student results, I will select the Results by Item button to see how the entire group performed on each test item. This report lists all of the test items, the claim and target for each item, the item difficulty, the Common Core State Standard to which each item is aligned, and the group's performance on each item. Click on the claim and target to see a description for each. Notice that there are information icons that explain each field. The full credit field shows the percentage of students in the group who earned the maximum number of points available for each item. All of the columns are sortable. By sorting on this column, you can quickly identify test items that students performed well on and items where students did not perform well. To the right of this column, you can see the percentage of students who scored at each score point. This can also be displayed as number of students by clicking the Show Value as Number button. To see individual student results for each item, click on the arrow to the left of an item number. We will look at item number 1. Now we see a roster of students with each student's score, the max score, and the correctness value. This field is a value for the degree of correctness in a student's response to a test question. The correctness value is calculated by dividing the student's score on a particular test item by the maximum score for that item. For a question with a max score of 2, the correctness value would be 0.50 if a student scored 1 out of 2 points. This column is sortable and will allow you to quickly identify students who performed well on this test item and those who did not perform well. All the columns are sortable. Clicking on the sort icon for students lists them in alphabetical or reverse alphabetical order. Clicking on the arrow to the left of each student's name shows the test item, including the student's response. I can't show you this because it will display actual interim assessment test items which may not be displayed publicly. The Item Viewer tab shows the item without the student response as it appears on the test. The Rubric and Exemplar tab shows the exemplar or correct response, any other possible correct responses to the item, and a rubric that defines the point values associated with specific responses. The Item Information tab describes the claim, assessment target, the Common Core State Standard that the item assesses, and for math items, if a calculator was allowed. Also provided on this tab are the depth of knowledge level, the item difficulty, and links to other supporting documentation. Clicking on the Results by Student icon brings us back to where we started. If you click on the icon to the left of a student's name, you will see the option to view the student's responses, test history that shows all the tests the student completed to date, and an option to print a report of the student's performance on all the tests the students took. Here is an example test history report for a student. You can also click on Student Report on this page to download a printable student report. This provides the option to select which reports to download and print. Here is an example of a printable IAB report. Click on My Groups to go back to the previous screen. The last feature that we're really excited about are the links to the instructional resources. Smarter Balanced is working with educators from our member states to develop connection playlists for each IAB. We currently have 11 connection playlists. The remaining 90 plus playlists will be made available in phase 2. The link to the instructional resources is at the top of the results page. The connections playlist for this IAB is not yet available. Here is an example of a connections playlist for the Grade 3 Math Number and Operations in Base 10 IAB. It describes the skills that students within each reporting category are working to solidify and provides educator-recommended next steps and digital library resources. Visit the digital library for more information about the connections playlists. This brings us to the end of our demonstration. Thank you for viewing this video about the new reports and features of the Smarter Balanced reporting system. Be sure to check out the user guide if you need more information about the new features and instructions to navigate through the system. I also suggest that you read the Interim Assessments Interpretive Guide. It's a great resource that will help you better understand how to interpret the results as you make decisions about next steps for instruction.